Hello friends, let's talk on Sirolimus. So Sirolimus is the immunosuppressant agent. Sirolimus, it is the immunosuppressant agent. It belongs to the category called as mTOR inhibitor. So it is the mTOR inhibitor and it is used as immunosuppressant agent. The mechanism of action is, so Sirolimus mechanism of action. So when the sirolimus is given, sirolimus, it will bind with the protein. So it will bind with the FKBP, that is FK506 binding protein, and because of that it inhibits the enzyme mTOR. See, the tacrolimus, it also binds with the FKBP, but their binding site is different than the sirolimus, and they inhibit the sirolimus binds with the FKBP and inhibit the mTOR. That is why they inhibit the T cell proliferation, and because of this T cell proliferation is inhibited, so they reduces the immune response, and hence it is having the immunosuppressant property. The pharmacokinetics data, it is shows the sirolimus, it is given orally, so it is well absorbed orally, so it is used orally. The sirolimus, it binds, it is metabolized by metabolism. It is metabolized by the CYP3A4 enzyme, and the another important thing related to the pharmacokinetic, that their blood level monitoring is needed. So blood level monitoring is required. The important thing about the sirolimus is non-nephrotoxic. So sirolimus, it is non-nephrotoxic. So because of that, it is safe in case of renal transplant, or it is preferred on those patients who got the nephrotoxicity with the cyclosporine or the tacrolimus. So in that case, we can use the sirolimus. So that's the main thing about the sirolimus. It is renal safe. And generally, the sirolimus in combination with MMF, that is mycophenolate mofetil, with the corticosteroids, this combination, it is widely preferred in case of the renal transplant or in case of the patient who is having the nephrotoxicity with the cyclosporine or the tacrolimus. So that's a renal safe combination. Then another thing is the sirolimus. It is used in the coating of stent. So sirolimus is used in the sirolimus coated stent. They are used in the CAD patients. CAD, what is that? Coronary artery disease. Do you know, guys, the angioplasty? Angioplasty, where we have the two things. One is the balloon therapy and the stent therapy. But balloon therapy is nowadays less often used because of the re-stenting or because of the higher risk of artery rupture. While the stenting therapy, that's the main one, which is used in the PCI, or that is percutaneous coronary intervention, which is the main therapy for the during the MI, myocardial infarction. So stenting, where we have the stents. There are the two types of stent. One is called as the bare metal stent, which are not coated with the drugs. They are the bare
metal stent. And we have the another stent which is called as the drug-eluting stent. Drug-eluting stent. What's the difference between these two? In the bare metal stent, the risk of restenosis is high. And to overcome these side effects, the drug-eluting stent came into the market. And the most preferred drugs are, the one is the Sirolimus and another is paclitaxel. Paclitaxel and Sirolimus. So these are the drugs which is used in the stent, and they are coated. So the drug is coated over the stents, and then that stents are implanted into the patient who is having the heart attack. So what is the purpose of this? They are the paclitaxel is the cytotoxic agent, which is anti-cancer agent, and sirolimus is an immunosuppressant agent. What they both do is they inhibit the endothelial cell proliferation. Endothelial cell proliferation, and that's why they reduces the risk of restenosis. They are reduces the risk of restenosis. So sirolimus coated stents are used in the CAD patients, coronary artery disease patient. So that's where the sirolimus is being used. That's what important thing is. The another thing is the sirolimus, it is avoided, or it is less preferred into the liver disease patient. So it is avoided or contraindicated, like it's avoided into the liver damage patients. The only reason is it is because of their adverse effect. So let's see their adverse effects. Their adverse effect is the bone marrow depression. Specifically, they are reducing the platelet counts, which is called as thrombocytopenia. The another is they increases the serum lipid level. They increases the serum lipid level. They causes the liver damage, and that's why we are avoiding this in the liver disease patient. Then in case of the, it causes the pneumonitis, and another is the diarrhea. So they are the major adverse effects of the sirolimus. So that's a short note of sirolimus. Sirolimus is actually the mTOR inhibitor. The sirolimus is immunosuppressant agent, which is belonging to the category of mTOR inhibitor. Sirolimus mechanism, it binds with the FKBP. So FKBP, that's a FK506 binding protein, and their binding sites and the binding site of the tacrolimus is different. So they bind with this protein and inhibiting the mTOR. That's why they reduces the T cell proliferation, that reduces the immune response. The sirolimus, do you know the earlier name of sirolimus? It was known as rapamycin. It was launched at rapamycin. It was discovered in 1960, and it was launched as macrolide antibiotic. It was launched as macrolide antibiotic, and it has the three property. It is antibiotic. It is having the antifungal effect as well as it was immunosuppressant. It is immunosuppressant. It is immunosuppressant. So nowadays we are just using this drug for this purpose, immunosuppressant. So that's why this target, or where this rapamycin is binding, that protein is called as mammalian target of rapamycin. Rapamycin is the earlier name of, or it was the old name of sirolimus. So it was launched as macrolide antibiotic. If someone asks you,
Which immunosuppressant agent is having the structure similar to the macrolide antibiotic? So there were three. The one is the Sirolimus, Tacrolimus, and Everolimus. And this is the protein where it is acting. The best thing about the Sirolimus is it is the renal safe. So it is safe in the kidney, and that is why it is preferred into the patient who is having the who wanted to have the renal transplant, or those patients who have the nephrotoxicity in the cyclosporine or tacrolimus use, where this combination is best. Then the sirolimus coated stents, they are also being used in the CAD patients. Why? Because the sirolimus, it is immunosuppressant agent, it inhibits the immunity, thereby they inhibit the proliferation of the endothelial cells, and thereby they reduces the re-stenosis. So risk of re-stenosis is lower in that case. So generally the paclitaxel or sirolimus, which is used widely in the drug eluting stents, that's just a basic. Then it is used orally, metabolized by CYP3A4. Then all the agent which is used as immunosuppressant, mostly with the cyclosporine, tacrolimus, sirolimus, everolimus, where the blood level monitoring is needed. They are having the liver damage side effects, so that's why they are taken care with the liver damage patients. So we need to avoid them if possible. And adverse effects are bone marrow depression, where specifically they reduces the platelet counts. They increases the serum lipid levels. They have the liver damage as a side effect. They causes the pneumonitis and diarrhea. So that's a short note on sirolimus. Thank you so much. Thank you.